Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Good morning, Dr. Kane and Mace. Welcome to the Valder Beebe Show for the first time. It's my pleasure to talk with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Dr. Kane, we're going to start with you. I'd like you to talk about the topic that we're going to talk about so people can understand mental illness.
Sure. Well, mental illness affects about one in four families, so it's very common. Most people are touched by this. And I think we've done a reasonable job of reducing some of the stigma associated with mental illness so people are more willing to talk about it and come forward and seek treatment. But we're particularly interested in schizophrenia, which is an illness that affects about 1% of the population. So in the U.S., there are 2.5 million adults suffering from schizophrenia. In Texas alone, there are 230,000 adults suffering with schizophrenia. So we want to increase awareness about potential treatment options and so that people can get the best treatment available to them and help improve the outcome.
I want my audience to know that Dr. John Kane is the Senior Vice President of Behavior Health Services of Northwell Health, and he's the chairman of the psychiatric at the Zucker Hillside Hospital and May. Let me ask you, you brought a guest today. May, if I could ask you, you have an adult son, Jason. Can you tell me about your experience with Jason and the topic that Dr. Kane spoke on, schizophrenia?
Yes, Jason was diagnosed when he was a young adult. It was a very confusing time for us. It was a time of a lot of trial and error because we were trying to help Jason to understand his symptoms. We were also trying to work with the doctors to come up with a good treatment plan. But the problem was that Jason kept forgetting to take his medication. And so that caused problems because it wasn't could not be effective if he couldn't remember to take the medication.
And so how are you with treatment now and medication?
Well, Jason is doing very well now. Like I said, at first there was the problem of remembering to take the medication. I remember that we would make a call to him every night to ask him, Jason, did you remember to take your medication today? And often his answer was, Mom, I'm not sure if I took it or not, or maybe I think I took it this morning, but I'm not sure. And so he would take another one. But it wasn't until about 10 years into his treatment and after the third hospitalization that we were introduced to the idea of a long-acting injectable. And that meant that Jason would take his medication through an injection, and he would do that every month. Not every night taking a pill, but just once a month. And so you can just imagine the relief that we felt when I didn't have to make that call every night. And I just wish that we had been told about this treatment plan early on, because I think we probably would have made some different decisions if we had known about this early.
Thank you so much, Meg. Dr. Kane, tell us a little bit about this treatment plan that seems to have revolutionized May, her son, and their journey.
Well, we think it's important that obviously that patients get the benefit of the medicine that's being prescribed. Of course, you know, any medicine has benefits and risks, and people need to talk to their healthcare provider. But in any illness, people have trouble taking medicine on a daily basis. It doesn't mean you're a bad patient or a bad person. It's human nature to have trouble taking medicine, whether you have diabetes or hypertension or what have you. So the fact that we have long-acting injectable medicines available is very important. So May and I have partnered with Janssen Pharmaceuticals to try to increase awareness that patients and families do have this option, receiving their medication by injection rather than having to take pills every single day.
And how can my audience, I know they're listening, people who listen to the Valder Beebe Show, they tell me 5.4 million of them across the country in different ways. They're looking for answers. They're not just being entertained. So how can they find out about this that seems to have energized May and her son?
Well, the National Council for Behavioral Health has a website that does provide a guide on long-acting injectable antipsychotic drugs, and that's available at the website, thenationalcouncil.org/LAMS, and we recommend that as a source of information.
I would also, I would also add to that that anyone can talk to their healthcare professional about treatment options. And so I would encourage anyone who has a diagnosis of a severe mental illness to talk to their doctor about the possibilities of other kinds of treatment options that might be available.
May, thank you so very much for once again kind of making this not such a stigma, just a part of life. And maybe people can deal with it better. And Dr. Kane, thank you for being one of the leading doctors, they told me, in the field. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com. Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I have used Credit Help USA, the credit restoration company that's bonded and state certified. When you become a client of Credit Help USA, you become eligible for a set of stainless steel cookware from Credit Help USA and the Valder Beebe Show. Get your credit straight today. Visit credithelptx.com, click on the Valder Beebe Show icon, and get started living life divinely.